Welcome to the 2021 Heart of America Athletic Conference Women's Soccer Media Day. I'm Erik Bergrud, color commentator for the Kansas City Comets of the Major Arena Soccer League. Next up, we are joined by head coach Dan Schmidlin of Central Methodist. Coach, how are you doing today?
Great. How are you?
I'm doing well. Talk to us a little bit about preseason. How is your preseason camp going there at Central Methodist?
Yeah, it's going good. It's a little unique because we just kind of finished up here in May. So it's finished one season and then a couple months off, and then now it's a new group. So, but it's been a great preseason, and we got a couple scrimmages coming up. So looking forward to seeing how those go.
Very good. So you've had a great run the last few years with three Heart titles in the last four and success at the national level. What have been some keys to that success over the past few years?
There we go. Sorry about that. I think, we built a good foundation, and I think we have a great culture here, and, you know, it's players maybe before the groups that won conference championships kind of helps set that foundation. So it's not just, you know, it just doesn't come out of nowhere. So it's something that we've been, you know, working on and striving for, and it's always been part of our goals to reach, and you know, it started to happen, and we've had some really good teams over the last several years, and looking forward to see what the future holds with this current team, and you know, it's constantly looking to try to improve on the previous year. You know, we want to make new history every year, so trying to challenge the current team to, all right, we got to go further than the Elite Eight. And, you know, obviously you're trying to win a national championship. And, you know, that's kind of been what we've done. You know, we set core values that we've been, you know, doing everything based every day in training, every game, you know, certain things that myself and coaches have come up with, and players as well. So there's been a lot of pieces to the puzzle. You know, it's previous coaches, it's previous players. There's a lot of tradition. So yeah, there's a kind of a loaded answer for you, loaded question, but there's a lot of pieces to it for sure.
So you referenced coming back from the spring. You had a 20 win season and a season unlike any other. What do you hope that your team takes from them with last year, a fall spring schedule, into this year, as far as what they learned from the difficulties dealing with such a long season and both in the classroom and on the field?
Yeah, I mean, it's a grind. It's just, you know, I think that's how good the Heart of America is too. So, you know, you have to be able to adjust and adapt and make changes and, you know, be coachable and want to learn and want to be great in the classroom and on the field. So, you know, it was definitely a lot of ups and a lot of downs. And I think you got to, you know, be able to weather the storms, and you can't get too high, can't get too low, and stay the course every day. And, but yeah, I hope we learned how to, you know, appreciate being on the field, you know, cause it was something that was almost taken away from all of us. You know, it was very last June. We didn't even know if we were going to have a season. And I think, being grateful for what we were able to, you know, whenever we were able to train, we made the most of it. Whenever we were able to play a game, we made the most of that. And, you know, you really learn when things get kind of taken away from you, like the previous spring. So, a lot of learning lessons to be honest, that, you know, this game is wonderful, but it can be taken away at any point. So, yeah. And, you know, I think people get so caught up on schedules and not being able to, you know, you can only control so much. And we talked about that with our team, and there's going to be things in life that get thrown your way, and you have to be able to deal with that as well. And very similar in sports too. So yeah, definitely adapt and adjust and ready for the next challenge.
So you referred to the Heart. Coach, what makes the Heart one of the toughest conferences in NAIA?
Honestly, I think we got really good coaches, and I think all the coaches have really good programs, and they've every year, you know, it's a grind, because I think when you have good coaches and you have people that are going to put the time in and recruit and get the players here and then coach them and work with them daily and not take shortcuts, it makes everybody really good. And I think we challenge each other. You know, there was always teams ahead of you that you're trying to knock off, you know, and before we won our title, we were chasing Benedictine, trying to beat Benedictine, and Benedictine made us better because we had to find ways to beat them. And you go back before that, like Graceland won like 12 straight championships or 10, something ridiculous. And teams were trying to figure out how to beat them. And I think all the coaches and all the teams and the players all push every institution to be the best every day, or you're going to get beat. You know, if you don't play well, you're going to lose in this conference. And, you know, you take shortcuts and you don't prepare, you're going to lose. So I think that's what does it, to be honest.
One of the great features, this will be my last question, Coach. One of the great features of the Heart are the fans. Home fans, visiting fans that travel with the team. What should fans expect when they come to Fayette on game day this year, both your fans as well as fans from other teams?
Yeah, I mean, we want it to be a top level environment. You know, we want our fans, we want our parents, we want our student body, we want our administrators, we want as many people as we can get to the games, to where it's you know, a little bit of a crazy environment, a home field advantage. And we want it to be a tough place to play. You know, we want to go into Central Methodist knowing that it's a tough place to play. So that's the goal of the fans. And, you know, obviously we want them rowdy, and we want them, you know, obviously appropriate. You know, we don't want them to do anything that crosses the line there, but, you know, we want it to be a rowdy environment and a good overall experience for both teams, you know.
Very good. Coach, thank you so much for joining us today, and good luck this season.
Appreciate it. Thank you.